We have continuing coverage of this weekend's Mavericks Invitational Surf Contest. Now, if you missed what we did yesterday, the Giant Wave Surf Contest is now on for Sunday. Right now, some of the world's best surfers are on their way to the Central Coast. 24 will participate. 8 of them are from Santa Cruz. Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live in Santa Cruz with more on the hype and all the buzz. Phil?
Well, Dan, as you know, the call's gone out, and the big wave surfers are coming in from around the world for the Mavericks Big Wave Contest held this Sunday in Half Moon Bay. Santa Cruz will be well represented. 8 of the 24 big wave surfers come from the Central Coast. We spoke to 3 of the competitors today as they get ready for the contest after a 3-year hiatus.
Actually, I heard through the grapevine that they called the green.
We don't realize sometimes because it's not like other sports. We're really waiting for that
really
perfect
need
day.
To be mentally ready, and I've done it where I just get the call, get in the truck, and go.
For the first time in 3 years, Mother Nature has delivered conditions worthy for the Mavericks Invitational, which will begin this Sunday morning at 8. Usually competitors get a call a day before the competition. This time they got time to prepare for it.
It's pretty nerve-wracking, and it's your adrenaline wants to get going days before, and you want to just start getting, you know, you start getting excited. But man, you really got to stay calm and just focus. They could have called it last minute and I'd be fine, but I think it helps out the guys from Brazil and South Africa. It lets them, you know, kind of get organized more and just more peace of mind.
This year's waves are not expected to be as big as the ones contestants encountered in 2010, which towered more than 40 feet in the air, but they will be powerful and hard to ride.
They're going to be really powerful, probably going to be really hollow too. I mean, we got perfect wind conditions.
It's going to be super dangerous. You know, it's going to be tough conditions. It's going to challenge us.
The best way to see the action will be via live webcast or at a festival on the grounds of the Oceano Hotel and Spa at Pillar Point Harbor. An estimated 10 to 15,000 people will watch the contest on big screen TVs. The surfers will be competing for $50,000 in prize money. The winner will receive $12,000.
We'd be out there anyways, no money or, you know, we'd just...
We're not doing it for the prize money. We're doing it because we love it. And, I mean, the fact that there's even some prize money is so generous. And we're
really happy we're going to have an event. And I can't wait.
Now, parking is at the Half Moon Bay Airport. It'll cost you $10 to park there. If you purchase tickets online for the festival, it'll cost you another $10. If you pay at the door, it'll cost you $20. The festival doors open at 8 a.m. Dan?
We're hoping it's going to be a big one. Thank you, Phil. Appreciate it. The Mavericks Big Wave competition is also going to be streamed live. That'll be at mavericksinvitational.com and on surfline.com. And if you want to see the action in person, it's very difficult, if not impossible, to see the surfers from shore. In fact, you don't want to be there. The bluffs at Half Moon Bay will be patrolled by police, and they don't want you there. It's not safe for you to be there. Place to watch is at the festival that Phil was talking about, at the Oceano Hotel. That's in Half Moon Bay. They're going to have big screens, and you'll be able to actually see the surfing from there.
Meantime, the Oceano Hotel's phones were offline for a good chunk of the morning. Callers could not get through from about 7 this morning until 2 this afternoon. The hotel tells Action News they're not sure what caused that problem, but the phone company was able to come out and fix the phones. And just in case you're looking for a room there, they are completely sold out Saturday night. Rooms are still available, though, Friday and Sunday.